Crypt of the NecroDancer by Brace Yourself Games might be old news to many of you. It was released all the way back in 2015, and for those of you that missed it, this review is for you. Crypt of the NecroDancer is Guitar Hero meets Dance Dance Revolution meets Spelunky. It takes the best from the rhythm and roguelike genre, making an addicting and fun game you'll enjoy for hours on end. The game begins with you as Cadence, a girl determined to find her father who went missing in a crypt. She falls into the crypt, and begins a strange, electronic dance music-filled adventure. You battle your way through level after level of a crypt, and if you happen to die, which you'll be doing a lot, you start over from the beginning in typical roguelike fashion. The fresh and exciting part of the game comes with how you traverse the crypt. Everything you do in the game, everything, from moving to jabbing with your dagger or shooting a crossbow, is to the beat of the music. Even the trolls and skeletons can't help but to groove to the beat. Each level of the crypt is randomly generated, so each time you play is different. The layout of the dungeon, the location of the enemies, and the kinds of weapons you find. Sometimes you get really lucky and find a bow or a crossbow, which is pretty much a guaranteed win. Other times all you find is a spear or upgraded dagger, which really stretches your knowledge of the game's mechanics and each monster's dance. Each monster has its own movement pattern to go along to the music. The golem shimmy, the mushrooms do the truffle shuffle, unintended of course, and there are about a dozen bosses that each have really unique patterns and dance moves. There is a chess game with deep blues, and you can do the conga with King Conga. Mastery of the game is not only mastering your own movement in combat, but learning how to boogie with each of the many monsters in the crypt. The difficulty of the game is always ramping up. The first area has simple enemies, with movements easy to follow and memorize. The slimes just move up and down or in a square pattern, and the skeletons move towards you every other beat. My favorite enemy, however, comes in the last zone of the game, and it's much more complicated. There are these knights that come at you with a sword and always parry your first attack. After they parry your attack, they charge in with a counterattack on the next beat, and only then are they vulnerable to your damage. The amount of enemies also ramp up as you make it deeper into the crypt. As the game goes on, it goes from a leisurely dance to a frantic fandango. Sometimes you'll be so swarmed by enemies that you'll nervously miss the beat of the music. Fortunately, the designers didn't want to punish you too greatly. When you miss a beat, you miss one movement and lose a score multiplier. When the game was in development, there was a time that losing the beat damaged you, but they decided that was too punishing, and thank goodness for that, because the high-stakes situations are way too frequent, and I find myself nervous all the time. As you make your way through the main story, you unlock new characters that each have a unique trait. One of them has a weapon that deals damage all around them, so you strafe around enemies to do damage. Another has a power that allows them to control the beat. All the other enemies move only when you decide to, giving you plenty of time to think out each movement you and everyone else will be making. There is so much content stuffed into this game that I didn't even get to experience it all, as some of it requires some really hard challenges, like beating the whole game with only half of a heart available. But even with those difficult challenges to complete, I really loved Crypt of the NecroDancer. I'll be coming back to it again and again for years to come. I give it a 9 out of 10, and definitely recommend that you watch for this one to go on sale on Steam.